Hi, I'm Greg Hollows and welcome to the Imaging Lab. We're going to look at detail about depth of field during this session. Depth of field is the ability to maintain resolution above and below best focus of the system that the optics is being utilized in. We looked at some examples of this in the basic portion of the section from earlier tape, but we're going to really get into more detail about why things occur and what we can expect out of different lens systems under different resolution requirements. If you remember back to our original session, we were looking at the example of these two golf balls being placed at different distances away and the ability to get good focus on them at the different distances, where best focus is the ball next to my head and the area that of the depth of field concerns the one in my right hand at a distance. If you remember back to that, the cutaway example that we had showed that we were actually getting different depth of field depending on the F number of the system. A very popular understanding about depth of field is I adjust my iris setting, closing my aperture down and making it smaller in the lens, thus increasing the F number, I can get better depth of field, basically better resolution at a distance further away from best focus. And that's a reasonable rule of thumb to use, and the laws of physics do prove out that that's what occurs. But there's some things to keep in mind when we actually start to understanding depth of field. As you can see in the slide, as we adjust the iris setting up and down in this particular example, something else occurs here as we're actually adjusting the iris, changing the F number. We actually get more diffraction in the system. What does that mean? That means the smallest possible spot or piece of information I can resolve actually gets larger at best focus. My ability to actually maintain good resolution in the system at best focus goes down as I adjust my iris setting. Many imaging systems, this is not totally understood or even realized because the resolution of the system is low enough that these effects really aren't seen as being a problem. With the advent of higher resolution sensors, we're seeing some difficulties in this area. When we start adjusting the iris and thus increasing the F number, these spot sizes get large enough that they exceed the ability to actually image onto the small pixels associated with these high resolution systems. This will actually lead us to not be able to get resolution at any level if adjusted too far. This can be seen in low resolution systems if we push lenses to F20 or F30, let's say, but in high resolution systems, this comes into being a problem when we're running around F8 or higher. It's important to understand that getting good depth of field is a combination of the actual design of the system and the F number setting. As we can look in the next slide here, we can get an understanding of why this occurs and how we actually get better depth. If we look at the dashed lines in the slide, we'll notice that on the top portion of it, they're coming from the outer edges of the lens system. They're creating a very oblique angle going into where best focus is, which is at the blue line. You will notice that as they come down and hit these sections, if you were trying to get focus at a certain spot size or certain detail that's very, very tiny, they're going to miss that, or they're going to be much larger than that as they go through the focus portion of the system and not able to get good resolution there. So we look at the bottom picture in the slide. We're going to notice that the aperture is closed a bit, as denoted by the dotted lines, again, showing a much smaller portion of the aperture that's actually being used. These angles come into best focus at lower ray angles, and we're getting longer distances in the cones that we're actually able to see the resolution at. This is giving us better depth of field. We think about, though, with these iris settings getting low and the diffraction limit issues that come into play and the bigger spots that get caused by diffraction, eventually we're not going to get resolution at all, like I said earlier. Let's look at some real-world examples. We're going to do this on something called a depth of field target. You can see one of these in the slide that is up now, and you'll actually notice that it's a wedged piece of material with lines running down it at a 45-degree angle from the lens system. This allows us to get an area of best focus and see what the resolution is doing both above and below it. What we're going to do is we're going to look at a couple different lenses that have been designed here and serve different applications. We're going to see how they actually perform at the different focus settings. In the first one, we're going to see that at the best focus position, as we go through the iris settings, the resolution does slowly degrade over time. And that's to be expected, as we talked about with diffraction. What we'll also notice, though, as we start going through the iris settings at a different depth of field position, something that is closer to the lens system, that the actual resolution does appear to get better to a point, and then it goes back down again because the overall diffraction limit of the system is being pushed, and we're not able to get resolution anymore. Let's look at a different example of a different lens that has some different capabilities to it. It was designed differently for applications actually for close-up work, typical of machine vision and industrial imaging. We'll notice here as we go through the different iris settings on this particular lens, we're maintaining good focus across the range. Resolution is starting to drop down at this best focus position a little bit, but when we examine the actual depth of field points, what we see is actually better imaging capability as we continue to step up through those focus positions. the depth of field is going up, and we haven't pushed all the way to the diffraction limit, but we're seeing much clearer lines. Now, these two examples, we're both looking at the same field of view. Some things that come into play here is the focal length of this particular lens, the actual f-number setting, and the design capabilities of the lens. One was pushed way outside of its design to begin with and wasn't able to hold up even as we went through the iris settings. The other one held up much better due to its design. Let's look at one last example. We're going to talk about high resolution imaging for a second. We're going to do this a little bit differently. We're going to look at different resolutions. We're going to look at a resolution very close to the pixel limited resolution of the system. And we're going to look at something that's about 3 times coarser resolution. What we're going to see here is when we look at best focus in these systems, we're going to compare them at 2 different F numbers. It's going to be the same lens, but at 2 different resolutions. As we look at the finest resolution in the system itself, at best focus, we're already up against the limits of what can be done at the particular F number setting, and the resolution is fairly low as you look at the blown up section. As we go to a different depth of field point, you can see there's no information at all to be gained there. As we go to the coarser resolution setting, we can see that there is good information that can be seen at best focus and some amount of information at that same height depth of field point as the finer resolution area. As we start to shut down that aperture setting, we're going to notice that all the resolution goes away because we've passed the diffraction limit and we're no longer able to get information at best focus or at any depth of field position. At the coarse position, the information is held fairly well at best focus. It has dropped a little bit in terms of contrast and resolution, but not much that's discernible. And we're getting better depth of field as we look at the higher level focus position. What's the important thing about this? It's really good to understand that as you move to higher and higher resolution imagers, your ability to maintain good depth of field or even get any sort of depth of field can be severely constrained by the laws of physics limits that the lens has wrapped around it. There's not much that's able to be done to improve this because there's no more room to actually improve the design or the manufacturing tolerances to get you any better. It's important to do this and factor this into your designs up front so that when you're going out and putting in high resolution imagers or very, very expensive camera systems that you've accommodated for this and that you may not be able to actually achieve what you're looking for because it could defy the laws of physics.
That's depth of field, and that brings us to the end of our first full module. You can feel free to click on any of the links that you see on the screen to take you back to some of the other topics that we've discussed or on to module 2 or beyond.